What's up, guys? I know in my last video I talked about having a Harley now, and I talked about how I would do a walk-around video or something like that, explaining all the parts on it, or I said I would show you guys it. So this video is just showing my 2007 Harley Davidson Nightster. I got it probably about a year ago. It had a chain drive and stuff already done to it, and some other little things, but I changed a lot of it, and I think it turned out pretty good. I'm still not done, but here's a video of like everything I have, all the little parts and stuff. I don't know if some of you will ask or not, but yeah, let's get into it. First things first, it's a 2007 Nightster, so these usually come with spoked wheels and everything like that. So not the first thing I did, but the main thing I did was I got mags off Craigslist. I picked them up for like $150, and then they were Timken bearings or whatever. I don't know how to say it, but they were the wrong bearings. The front one still mounted up fine, but the rear one didn't, so I had to sell that one and go with a newer year one. And it ended up working. I had a spacer made on the brake side. That helped out a lot. Made everything fit pretty well. And then, yeah, that's how the wheels got there. That's the main thing. Makes it look really good. They're way more durable than the spoked wheels, and I hate tubes. So, yeah, that's nice that it's tubeless now. I guess the next thing would be the air cleaner that's right in front of you and the Bassani exhaust, along with the chain drive. So I have an Arlaness stage 2 air cleaner along with the Bassani Road Rage 3 exhaust, along with a chain drive kit. Now the chain drive kit was already on there when I got it, so I think it was just thrown together. It wasn't a specific kit that was like made for this bike, but I did end up going with a Bun King 55 tooth rear sprocket and then Joker front sprocket cover right there. The next thing I did, I had a guy on Instagram that goes by Nightfall Customs. He custom made that Dirty Money outline over the intake right there. It turned out pretty good. He's really good. He'll do any custom lettering you want, and I'll leave a link to his Instagram below. And next thing I did, the black paint job. That was shout out to Greg, my best friend, who's Greg. I'll leave a link to his channel below on Instagram or whatever. But his work painted the whole bike. They always hook it up. He does a good job. And it turned out amazing. It's just a plain black. I actually have some decals on the way. I went with some silver decals for the tank, and then I have Thrasher Supply front pegs. They're nice. They're definitely expensive. The next thing I have would be the Legend Suspensions Revo A's. I went with the 130s, not on purpose. I did that on accident, but I just keep it on setting 2, and they seem pretty soft. So the 130s rate springs are for heavier duty bikes. They're not specifically made for lighter guys like me. I'm only like 150 pounds, so I kind of messed up on that, but they definitely helped the feeling of the bike, and it rides way better with them on there. So that was a nice upgrade right there. On top of them, I have the KedTech pegs. Them help it for like moving around on the bike, but I honestly don't like using them. The best thing I would use would be this Reckless sled ledge, and that's came in handy a lot. It's very nice, sleek looking, not very big. You can't really like put both feet on it, but I like the way it feels when you have one foot on there and the other foot on the foot brake. The next thing I'll talk about is this rear fender with a titanium plate I have. I had a local guy, Exploded Monkey, goes by on Instagram. I'll link him in the below as well. But he fabbed this rear fender up for me. Usually the Nightster has a shorter fender, so I went and grabbed one off of an older bike. I can't remember what year Sportsters are the fatter fenders, but I went and grabbed one of them and had him fab up that rear fender right there. So I can mount titanium and scrape it in a wheelie. He did an amazing job. It looks real good. And then I just have a single brake light right there with no turn signals or anything in it. Moving on from that, I have a Hohe dual cowl bracket. Just with some, like an R6 caliper and a 636 caliper on there as well. The foot brake on that, it literally fades out really fast, and I'm not a huge fan of it, but I guess it's there and it does its job for now, so I can't complain too much. But yeah, it does fade out really good. I don't know if it's because my rotor might be a little bent or anything, but that's going to be next on the chopping block, is doing a new rear rotor and maybe some different lines and seeing, maybe check the pads and everything like that. And that all fails. I don't even know, maybe new calipers, but it's hard to tell why it's fading out. I'm not like raping it, so it's tough to say. Moving on from there, I have a Saddleman step up seat, tuck and roll in the front, diamond stitching in the rear. I used to have the diamond stitching all around, but the tuck and roll, it seems way more comfy. The diamond stitching all the way around, it just didn't like lock me in a wheelie, so it felt kind of sketchy. And then I think this just kind of looks a little better. The diamond stitching looked good, don't get me wrong, but this is definitely a little bit more comfy for me, and I like it a lot more. And then I have the Thrasher Supply shift cover right there. Just some small little add-ons, but going on from there, the Roland Sands gas cap. And then the most important part of any bike would be the RSC lever. Easy pull lever, it makes everything like super easy, like pulling in the clutch, everything like that. I went with the two finger on this. I'm not sure if I'm a fan of the two finger, honestly. I might switch it back up and go with the one finger trigger style that he just came out with. And then I have a Brembo 16x18. So yeah, just a regular Master. I am running Honda Mini Pro Taper bars on this. So all the controls are 7/8. Everything was switched over. I'm a fan of it. It sucks because my front Master is like off of like a Grom. So you can kind of tell it's kind of junk, but it gets the job done. Not really, it doesn't really even allow me to lock up the front. I can't even do like a burnout or anything. And then like the rest on from there, I guess the last thing I've done is this Moons headlight. It turned out really nice. I like the way it looks, it's way brighter. It definitely made a huge difference. So yeah, I really like that headlight that I went with, and made the bike look real good. Definitely at night, it made a huge difference than the stock housing that was just a halogen bulb. But yeah, that's like a walk around of my bike. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments below and I'll try to answer them as best as I can. Supposedly when I bought the bike, it had a Barnett clutch, but that's definitely not true because it's already slipping. So maybe it is and I'm just rough on things, but we'll dig into that like in a week or two and see what's going on with that. But other than that, spent a lot of money on this bike, but I really enjoy it. It's fun to just cruise around on too, and it's fun to do some wheelies and scrape it, and it's definitely way different than the big bike, so I've enjoyed it so far. Also, just want to say sorry about all the noise. It's kind of by the interstate, so hopefully it's not too loud. But yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.